Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this beautiful day in San Francisco. Thank you so much for coming today. Here we are today celebrating the San Francisco Library's 125th birthday. We should all be so lucky, shouldn't we? I'm Sydney Kohara from KPIX CBS 5 in San Francisco, where I anchor the CBS 5 Eyewitness News early edition, getting up at 2:30 in the morning, so I'm very happy to see the sunshine out here. It's never there when I get up. It is my pleasure to serve as host of this event tonight. We have a great program for you this morning, starting, of course, with some fabulous music from the wonderful Archbishop Reardon High School Jazz Ensemble from San Francisco, under the direction of the great Tom Blount, Director of Jazz Studies. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Thank you so much, Tom, for bringing this great group here today, and you will hear them a little bit later on as well. It's my very great pleasure now to introduce the mayor of San Francisco, the Honorable Gavin Newsom.
Thank you very much.
Thank you all very much for being out here today. And got the helicopters watching the protests. My kind of day in San Francisco. Great weather, but windy. I'm honored to be here because I'm honored that we have such an extraordinary institution that's really, I think, distinguished the city and county of San Francisco. 125 years. Just think of the contributions that our public library system has made in the lives of literally hundreds of thousands of San Franciscans. Something at times you can almost take for granted, but something that I think we should pause and reflect upon, and that is the extraordinary cultural competency that distinguishes this public library system. And what I mean by that is 26, now almost 27 branches to this library, representing the diverse communities in the city and county of San Francisco. What makes this city great, not good, is the diversity of the people that come from all over the world to enjoy this city. And to chronicle that diversity, to allow that diversity to be disseminated through knowledge, through exploration, through what this library system offers, is indeed important. Just think of the collections in the main library behind me. Collections offering distinct focus on the contributions of the African American community, the Chinese community, the Filipino community, the extraordinary international collection we have here at the Main, the contributions of the communities represented by the gay and lesbian bisexual community, all again focused in this library system. It is a very proud tradition. This library system is a proud tradition in San Francisco, tradition that has been fostered and stewarded by the extraordinary staff, and we would be delinquent and remiss if we did not recognize the great contribution of our library staff and the great stewardship of Susan in her 5 years at the helm. In my capacity as mayor, I'm afforded opportunities like this to extend just 365 days a year, to extend a day honoring institutions and honoring people. Today I'd like to do both, in honoring again the collective group that represents the commission, our director, Susan, the staff, but also recognizing the entire system of public library here in San Francisco by proclaiming today, June 7th, 2004, not Biotech Day in San Francisco, not Helicopter Day or all those other things we have to do, but truly recognizing the day that distinguishes this day, and that's the 125th anniversary of the founding of our free public library system in San Francisco. Congratulations to all of you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor, Mayor Gavin Newsom, for taking the time out of your busy schedule. And I just have to let you know, I saw him, he's got a little cheat sheet with about 15 events that he has to take care of today. And he truly is a mayor who takes care of everyone in this city. So it really is wonderful that you took your time out to come to this library celebration again. Thank you very much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have a very special treat for you. Giving its blessing today on this fine institution and 125 years, the Kaelin Lion Dancers.
Thank you.
years. I'm sure there will be 125 more years of prosperity for the San Francisco Public Library. Thank you very much. But that's not all the entertainment we have this morning. Project Bandaloo, a dance company that honors nature, community, and the human spirit through performance, is with us today to celebrate with us the 125th anniversary. Ladies and gentlemen, we are thrilled to welcome Project Bandaloo. Right now, I would like to welcome City Librarian Susan Hildreth. Susan?
Well, thank you very much, Sydney. Mike, that is such a hard act to follow. My heart is still up here in my throat after watching the ladies of Project Vandaloop. But Sydney, thank you so much for serving as our program MC. You know, I often have to take on that role here at the library myself, and in addition to all those other duties I have to do, and it's nice to have Sydney here today doing it for us. What a special day. Proclamations, lion dancers, aerial performers, jazz. This is just a typical life, day in the life of SF, as we know that, our wonderful community here. It's a great town, and we're so glad that you're all here today. Happy to have you all here to celebrate this wonderful day. I wanted to just make you folks aware of a couple special guests we have today. We have Catherine Dodd here from Nancy Pelosi's office, and they've given us a lovely resolution. Thank you, Catherine. Michelle Moss is here from Senator Boxer's office. Thank you, Senator Boxer. Anna Damiani from Mark Leno's office will be presenting a resolution in a little bit. We're going to call her up in a bit. And we also have a wonderful resolution from our Secretary of State, Kevin Shelley. So we know that we have friends in high places here at the San Francisco Public Library, and we thank you very much for all your support. Also, I just wanted to let everyone know that we have a number of our library commissioners here today. Charles Aguirre, our president, will be with us soon, but we also have Commissioner Helen Bautista here, Commissioner Carol Steinman over here, and I think that's it. If I haven't mentioned somebody, just wave your hand. Oh, Mr. Coulter, Commissioner Coulter's way in the back there getting the best view of Vandaloop that he possibly can. So thank you for all your support. Thank you for coming today. Also, our architects of this building, and even though the building was not designed to be a performance piece, it certainly is holding up well as one, and our architects, Kathy Simon, Anthony Bernier, and Bev Morris from the firm that worked on the building are here, so thank you so much for coming. There are many people that I need to thank who are here today. First and foremost, our wonderful sponsor, the Friends of the San Francisco Public Library. And I have to tell you, without them, this entire activity would not be possible, because I don't think Project Vandaloop is an authorized city vendor. I don't think we could get them a check, even if we had the money to. So the Friends are really helping us out today. It's through their generosity that we can present events like the ones today. They fund our exhibitions, programs, children's summer reading, special programs for adults and children in the branches, and much more. And right now, of course, they are raising funds to furnish and equip our branch libraries. Thank you to the Friends and to all of you, the citizens who support the Friends and the library through your votes, your use of the library, and your ongoing support. You are all a big part of what makes San Francisco such a special city, and I thank you also for being so gracious to me during my tenure here. I really appreciate all the support you give the library. Thank you so much. As some of you may know, I have decided to assume a new post in Tucson, Arizona as the director of the library there, and I'm sitting here thinking, you know, everybody tells me it's so darn hot there, but I doubt when I get there I'll be sitting in July with a wind like this where you can hardly keep your hat on. So I'll always remember the wonderful weather here in San Francisco. I also want to thank our media sponsors, the San Francisco Chronicle and KPIX-CBS5. You have been generous in your support and have helped us enormously in getting the word out about today's program. I would especially like to thank Rosemary Roach and the executives at KPIX, as well as Jane Tobin, Paulette Stracuzzi, and the executives of the Chronicle for making this event possible. I would also like to extend special thanks to our longtime friend of the library, Phil Frank. I don't think I've seen him yet today, but Phil Frank really is a library friend, and he has done wonderful cartooning featuring the library's 125th anniversary. And also, even if Frank isn't here, someone should ask him, where did he get that model for that old stodgy looking librarian that he used in there? We were afraid he was picking one of us here at the library. We couldn't figure out who that was, but I think he was just trying to create something generic. But we really do welcome and appreciate Frank. He does a lot for this library. And also thanks to City Guides for their support through neighborhood history programming in our branch libraries and guided walks in the surrounding neighborhoods. Please check out our schedules for a full list of activities in honor of the 125th anniversary. And also, just one last word, please check out our website, www.sfpl.org. We have wonderful things on there, a listing of the events and exhibitions. We have this wonderful library timeline that shows you a history of the library and what books were bestsellers back in the late 1800s and the early 1900s, a photo scrapbook, the Farley cartoons, and library memories, the first one being our wonderful Dr. Kevin Starr and his memory. Thank you for all of those who are sharing the podium with me today, and particularly Mayor Gavin Newsom, who made time on a very, very busy day here in town to be with us. So thank you all again for coming, and we'll turn it over to Sydney.
Thank you very much, Susan, and good luck with your new position in Tucson. We will miss you here. Right now, I would like to welcome to the podium Mr. Charles Egaris, President of the San Francisco Public Library Commission. Charles.
Thank you, Sydney. What a wonderful day, isn't it? You know, I'd gladly accept this wind if it guaranteed that we'd also get these cloudless, sunny skies. So I hope you all agree. This is an auspicious day, not just because 125 years have passed, but because it celebrates this institution as a powerful force in people's lives. In my 8 years as a library commissioner, what I've been most impressed by has been how much the residents of San Francisco love their library. As a native San Francisco, I count myself among them. And it's no wonder, really. The library is a welcoming place for all, no matter their age, their economic circumstance, language skill, or their country of origin. All of them use the library actively to borrow books, attend programs, collect skills, and yes, use technology. Even people who may not use the library very much or at all recognize the enormous contribution of a free and public library to a genuinely democratic society. We're very grateful for all the support that the library has received over the years. And in most recent time, by the passage of Prop E, which enables the reliable access to the library that we enjoy today, and Prop A, which was passed in 2000, which will be revitalizing our branch library system for another generation of users. Among all those who have over the years supported this institution, there are of course a number of significant persons who have done more than their share. In just a few weeks, we will be installing the history of the SFPL in the Larkin Street entrance here to the main library. Thanks to the considerable efforts of my fellow commissioner, Steve Coulter, we will be able to remind ourselves of the significant events and people that have formed this great institution. It promises to be truly inspiring. It's now my distinct pleasure to represent the commission in recognizing one such notable citizen and contributor to the legacy of the San Francisco Public Library, Dr. Kevin Starr. We have a resolution here which I'd like to read. It's brief. Whereas the San Francisco Public Library Commission is pleased to recognize, honor, and commend the many significant contributions which State Librarian Emeritus and former City Librarian of San Francisco, Dr. Kevin Starr, has made to improve California libraries during his years of service and leadership, and whereas the invaluable civic contributions of scholar librarian Dr. Kevin Starr, a highly respected historian, author, journalist, and university professor at the University of Southern California, teaching in its history department, and as a noted commentator on current events, has significantly enhanced the prosperity, cultural, economic, political, and social enrichment of our state and city and well-being of the people of San Francisco, the Bay Area, and indeed, all of California. And whereas the San Francisco Public Library Commission salutes California State Librarian Emeritus and former City Librarian of San Francisco, Dr. Kevin Starr, as an outstanding exemplar of the high ideals of professional achievement, personal character, and community leadership at its regular meeting of June 3rd, 2004. Therefore, be it resolved that the San Francisco Public Library Commission, the San Francisco Public Library and its users, in recognition and honor of his outstanding and exemplary leadership and dedicated hard work, and in recognition of his designation as the California State Librarian Emeritus, do hereby recognize, honor, and commend Dr. Kevin Starr.
Thank you very much. I'll just be very brief. First of all, the nearly five years I spent as city librarian here in San Francisco are among the happiest of my life. You look out this great plaza, and you have a complete orchestration of what it is to be a San Franciscan, with government, with the courts, with the Asian Art Museum, with the library, with the great Bill Graham Auditorium, a tremendous sense of this marvelous city. When my great-grandfather came to San Francisco in 1852 from Ireland, there was not a public library. There are many private libraries in San Francisco, but not a public library. And I think that the establishment of this library in 1879 showed San Francisco coming of age. Those of you who saw that wonderful movie, The Last Samurai, remember that scene where Tom Cruise is atop Nob Hill having the dinner with the Japanese officials, and he comes out on top of Nob Hill, and you can see the cable car coming up the city, coming up the hill. It was a beautiful shot. That cable car was inaugurated in 1873 by Andrew Halliday, the same person who stimulated the formation of this public library. And I think that if you look back in history, you'll see that all great cities have had great libraries. All cities want to remember, want to inventory, want to store the accumulated knowledge of the human race. We love our libraries, we San Franciscans. That's why we support so many of them in terms of our branch system. That's why we've been, and I'm a San Francisco voter all my life, that's why we've been so generous in terms of the propositions to construct the new library here and the branch libraries. This library and the entire library system is available for us throughout our lifetime. When we're young, it's available to us in the children's room. As we go to school and continue our education, it's available to us as we develop our talents. In later life, in retirement, it's available to us as we go back and read those books we didn't have time to read in previous years of our lives. It's a great privilege to get this commendation from as a fourth generation San Franciscan from my native city. As a professional librarian, I've had the privilege of being City Librarian of San Francisco, than which there is no more distinguished and fulfilling position in the library world. Thank you, and what a wonderful day for libraries and for San Francisco. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Starr, Dr. Kevin Starr. Please welcome to the podium now, Ann Damiani from Assemblyman Mark Leno's office. Ann?
Good morning, everyone, and welcome. I echo everyone's sentiments on expressing what a glorious day in San Francisco it is. I'm actually here on behalf of Assemblyman Mark Leno, Speaker Pro Tem of the Assembly Leland Yee, and President Tempore of the Senate, the Honorable John Burton. And I've brought a resolution for the library. I want to take a quick moment, though, to say what an honor it is for me to be here. I moved to San Francisco approximately 27 years ago, and one of the first things that I did that made me feel like a real San Franciscan and like I really lived here was that I got my library card, and it had my name on it, and it said San Francisco Public Library. That made me feel great because it really made me feel like I belonged. And it was that building right over there in a few years ago. Anyway, I'd like to take a moment and read a few passages from this resolution, which states a lot of wonderful things about the library and gives some great history. Whereas in 1879, the first free public library opened its doors with 5,656 books. However, it was a reading room only, and a wire fence protected the tomes from theft by the masses. In 1881, the public was allowed to withdraw books free of charge. The library grew quickly and soon outgrew the first building. The collection moved to City Hall in 1887, but the disastrous 1906 earthquake and fire decimated some 140,000 of the collected 160,000 volumes at the time. Whereas the Andrew Carnegie Foundation assisted the construction of the main library with $375,000 that helped build the main library in 1915, Carnegie donated another $375,000 for assistance with San Francisco Library's branch system. And Carnegie's contributions are gratefully acknowledged with a transcription which still stands inside the main library. Whereas the main library continued growing rapidly and reached 500,000 books by 1944, today the library contains over 3 million texts, with approximately one-third residing in the main building. And the entire system contains 27 facilities and stores, over 37 miles of text in various collections. It's pretty amazing. And whereas the new main library offers research and study areas plus an interactive center, the public can walk in off the street, be on the internet via high-speed hookup, and in seconds, the library, the city, and numerous public, private, and nonprofit agencies have linked together to build bridges in cyberspace using the library system as the main causeway. Now, therefore, be it resolved by Assemblymember Mark Leno, Speaker pro tempore of the Assembly Leland Yee, and President pro tempore of the Senate John L. Burton, that they take great pleasure in drawing the attention of the public to the San Francisco Public Library on the occasion of its 125th anniversary. Commend the library and its staff for providing valuable resource services to the community and extend best wishes for the library's continued success. And it's signed Assemblyman Mark Leno, Leland Yee, and John Burton. Susan?
Thank you. Lovely. There you go.
Thank you very much.
I'm just going to say one thing. We are so lucky to have good support from all our legislators in Sacramento. And I'll just say to all the staff here, remember us in those Prop 14 applications. We have 5 in there. We want to get at least 1. But we are blessed to have good legislators in Sacramento. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ann Damiano. Right now, I'd like to introduce Martin Gomez, Executive Director of the Friends of the San Francisco Public Library.
Good morning. Thank you very much, Sydney. I'll be very brief. It's my pleasure on behalf of the Friends of the San Francisco Public Library to sponsor this event for all of you to attend today. This is a year-long celebration. The Friends have been around not quite as long as the San Francisco Public Library. We're only 43 years old, but over that time, we have been very successful in providing additional support for this library, as well as advocacy in the form of new legislation. We'd like to invite all of you to become actively involved with the Friends of the Library. We have membership table to the right. There's also commemorative t-shirts that identify this celebration today with the artwork from Phil Frank, as well as a publication that was produced when this building was opened called A Free Library in the City, written by historian and local San Franciscan Peter Wiley. So what do you do when you have a birthday party? You're supposed to give presents, aren't you? Well, the Friends of the San Francisco Public Library are very pleased today to give the library a very special present. Mr. Higueras and City Librarian Susan Hildreth, we'd like to present to you from the Friends of the San Francisco Public Library. Now, we couldn't wait on this. We were supposed to really give it to you later, but we couldn't wait because we hear you're getting out of town. We'd like to give you a check for $725,000.
Thank you very much, Mr. Martin Gomez.
You know, I have done a number of projects for the San Francisco Library, but it really pleases me to be here because I remember growing up in Louisiana and, you know, you talk about San Francisco being a big city. It's really made up of so many small neighborhoods. The neighborhood I grew up in was one small street, a gravel street in Louisiana. If it wasn't for the bookmobile coming during the summer, which really broadened my horizons, I figured the only way I'd ever visit San Francisco was on my honeymoon, and here I am able to live in this wonderful Bay Area and be a part of this community. So the library goes back a long way for me, and I know for each and every one of you, you know the power of a book. Right now, Project Bandaloop returns performing excerpts from another original piece, Stories of Gravity and Transformation. Original musical scores for this dance were written by Raymond Granlund and Zachary Carratine. Please welcome back Project Bandaloop.
Thank you.
big round of applause, Project Vandaloo. Thank you, Project Vandaloo. On behalf of the San Francisco Public Library, thank you so much for coming out and enjoying all that the library has to offer, and I hope you continue to support this grand public institution. Thank you so much for coming. Good afternoon, everyone.